My chicken is bald. What do we do? Hello everyone and welcome back to the Rockingchomestead Homestead. This is Marcy coming at you. And today we've brought you outside to our chicken and goat area. And we're gonna talk about chickens and molting season because we're full on into molting season here right now for some of our chickens. Hey, while I've got you here, can I encourage you to subscribe to our channel? We got the subscribe button right down here. If you'll just click on that subscribe button and ring the bell, you'll know every time we upload a new video. And also we're on Facebook and Instagram. We'll have the links down below. We'd love for you to come and join us there as well. So let's go take a look at what we got going on here in the chicken coop. Well, it's late fall here in central Oklahoma. The temperatures have gotten colder and the days have gotten shorter. And that means it's time for the chickens to start molting. Molting isn't a particularly attractive process for the chickens, but it's necessary for them. And in this video, we're gonna tell you a little bit about why they molt, when they molt, and what you need to do to help them through that process. So far, our experience with our chickens has been pretty low key with the molting. They've done it kind of slowly, hardly even noticeable. We've noticed just a little bit of feather loss on some of our chickens. But this fall, for the first time, we've had a couple of chickens that have gone to the extreme with the molting process. So a little bit about molting. Molting is something that chickens do yearly. Hardly ever with younger, new layers. They usually don't molt like that in their first year. After that, they molt about once a year, usually in the fall, although it can happen during different seasons at all. Most typically it happens in the fall. The reason why chickens molt is that during the year their feathers become broken and damaged, and the chicken's body just knows those feathers aren't fit anymore to help protect them during the cold winters to come, or cold winter months to come. And so they drop those feathers and then they grow in some brand new, beautiful, shiny feathers that will help keep them protected throughout the winter months. The two chickens that we have right now, or the two hens that seem to have the most extreme molting process right now, is one of our black turkeys, Smokey, and also one of our favorite, most all-time favorite chickens, Piccolo. And we'll run a little bit of video of their before and after here as I kind of talk through this process so you can kind of see what they look like before this happened and then now that they're in full molt. We have our theories why those two are the ones that are having the extreme molting. We think it has something to do with them having been broody a lot over the summer, and we've didn't really actually let them go through the process of hatching chicks. We kind of broke the brood for them, but they went through it several times. So that's our theory, not so sure, maybe. But all the other hens, the older hens, look like they maybe lost a little bit of feathers, but they seem to be doing it a little bit slower, methodical, like losing them, gaining them, losing them, gaining them. It wasn't like dropping them all at once, like these two hens kind of just dropped them all at once. So the molting process can vary in length, but anywhere from 2 weeks up to 12 weeks. We'll see how it goes with our two girls, but Smokey is already starting to grow in some new feathers and actually looking a lot better than she did even just 1 week ago. So hopefully she finishes the process quickly because we are heading into some colder winter months here in Oklahoma. Piccolo is just now at the end of having lost them all, and we're really crossing our fingers that she'll get her new feathers in quickly because she looks like she's feeling pretty cold because you can see her shivering a little bit. So we'll keep an eye on her and make sure she looks like she's doing okay. The chickens are molting, what do you do then? We know that why and the how long, but how can you help them through this process of molting? Because it's a little bit disturbing to one day walk out and all of a sudden your chicken has no feathers. So, and that's what happened in the case of Piccolo. It was like one day she was Piccolo and the next day she was Baldy. So we did a little research to see what we can do to kind of help ease her through this process. One of the things we found is that you should try to handle them as little as possible because they're sensitive while they're going through this process, and the handling can cause them pain and of course stress. It's already kind of a stressful process for them, so reducing stress for them, super important. Also, just to kind of keep an eye on the bullying and stuff that happens a little bit more during molting, make sure that they're not being hurt. And, you know, I don't know what to say about this guy. He's really wanting to make a cameo appearance on this video, and he's doing a fantastic job. Thanks, Huck.
You're missing your buddy, aren't you?
For nothing, bud.
Yeah.
Thanks, Huck, for nothing, buddy. Anyways, also you need to change up their diet a little bit. When they're going through the molting process, they need a little more protein. So some of your regular hen layer feed isn't quite as high in protein as you'd want. We fortunately still have some of the higher protein feed left over from our meat chickens, so we'll be mixing that in with their food to provide a little more protein for our molting hens. Roosters can also molt, but that's not the case for our guy here. He's also pretty young, so he may, if he molts, it won't be for another year or so. So you can increase high protein food items, like you can add more black oil sunflower seeds. You can actually give them some eggs. That's good protein. Other different kind of grains and stuff would be good. You can also find some fun recipes online for molt muffins. You can make up a special high protein treat for your chickens if you feel so inclined. I might do that later because I don't like to spoil my chickens. No malt muffins for you though, because you're naughty.
He really wants to get that feed.
He really wants that feed. I brought actually a bucket of food that has a little more of those high protein grains and black oil sunflower seeds that we can spread out for the chickens. So those are some of the things that you can do for your chickens while they're molting to kind of help them through the process. Also keep in mind that while they're molting, they're dedicating all of their body strength and power and stamina just to survive without feathers and to grow new feathers and to stay warm. So they're not going to lay eggs for you, and that's okay. They're going through a big process there, and just being aware of that, you're not going to get eggs while they're doing that. They tend to lay fewer eggs when the days get short and cold anyways, but while they're molting, probably you'll get nothing. While we're out here, I thought I'd give you guys just a quick update on our goats. As you can see from earlier video, Huck, he's doing great. He's his normal rambunctious self, and I think he's missing his brother Finn a little bit, because Finn will play with them and these two are not so interested. So we've still got them in their dating configuration, because so you can see Maisie here, and we really hope that this just doesn't all bulky winter hair. We hope that this is a baby goat, hopefully. We'll see. But we're going to keep the goats in dated configuration probably for another maybe week or so, and then we'll put them back into place. And then as soon as we get past the Christmas holiday, we'll have the vet come back out and do a pregnancy test on our three ladies to see if we are going to be expecting new baby goats at the end of March. And I hope you'll forgive any bumping up and down of the camera, because Huck is actually attacking the cameraman in his own special way. He just wants to play. He's a big boy. That's it for today on molting chickens. We hope you've learned something about why and when and what to do. If you've got other great tips and tricks for helping your molting chickens through this time, this season of their life, we'd love to hear about it. You can leave that in the comments below. We'd really appreciate that. So thanks for coming back and watching our video. If you're a new viewer, welcome. We're so glad that you're here, and hope that you'll hit that subscribe button while you're here. Might as well. Anyways, thanks again for watching, and from our homestead to yours, we hope that you have a great evening. We'll catch you on the next video. Bye. Why are you like this? Why are you like this? I don't get it. What's wrong with you, buddy?